Namaste, I'm Bhavna. I'm back in my kitchen today and I'm going to show you today a very special recipe from Surat and Gujarat. It is very popular during the festival called Chandi Padwa, and people distribute Ghari, and that's the special sweet distributed to all the relatives, the special relatives. And especially in the Surat district, this festival is celebrated with the great joy. So today I'm going to show you how easy it is to prepare this Ghari recipe. And here is the handy list for making the Ghari filling and the layer or the cover. And it makes about 9 to 10 Gharis, depend on the size. There are few pre-preparation is required if you want to save your time. And if you want to prepare it with a nice, you know, with the arrangement, nice, good, properly. So I have a, I use the coffee grinder to grind my pistachio and also the almond. Pistachio and almond I grinded into the coffee maker, and also the cardamom powder. And I have the pan heated already here. And keep the temperature on a medium heat. And the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to roast this rava. This rava I have is a semolina or suji. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to slightly roast this rava into the pan. And keep stirring. So roast this suji or semolina or rava on a very low heat. And we don't want to make it brown, just slightly till it changes the color just a little bit. So this is it. When you start seeing the smoke, you just want to take it off. And right away, keep something handy. Like I have this plate and I'm going to take out into the plate so that it doesn't get burned. All right, and it also cools down faster. Alright, and I'm going to use the same pan now. I'm just going to clean up a little bit. I clean up the same pan and I'm going to put it back onto the stove. My temperature of the stove is still on a medium heat. And to this, I'm going to add maybe half tablespoon of ghee. Just a half tablespoon. Now this, today I'm using this ricotta cheese. But normally, traditionally, the fresh mawa is used to prepare this sweet dish, but if you don't have the fresh mawa, you can use the ricotta cheese, or you can also make from the instant milk powder. You can make the mawa out of that milk powder. Earlier I showed the recipe of how you can make the milk mawa out of the instant milk powder, the instant dry milk. And here usually I only find the non-fat, but if you can find the one with the fat, you can just buy that one too. So whatever works best for you, it's just you can do that. And I'm going to post all the recipes, how you can make with the ricotta cheese, how you can make with the fresh mawa. I got this recipe actually from my sister, and she normally makes with the fresh mawa because she can get the fresh mawa. She lives in Canada actually, and she has access to the fresh mawa she can buy. So take out all the water if you see any water and drain out into the sink. Into the ricotta cheese if you find any water. So we're gonna add the ghee in here. The pan is already heated, so it will melt the ghee right away. And we don't wanna put so much of ghee because then it will break your ghari. So just put enough. So I have about a half tablespoon of ghee only. And to this, I am going to add this ricotta cheese. So I have about 1/4 cup of ricotta cheese. Now this ricotta cheese might splash back onto you, so be very careful with it. You can take it off of the stove if it starts splashing a lot. And keep doing that. Take it off of the stove and put it back on the stove. You can do that if you want to be just on the safe side. So basically what we want to do is that we want to let the water evaporate from this ricotta cheese. Make sure that it doesn't hold any water. So we're gonna cook till we kind of find just a little bit thick enough and we are sure that there is no water left in there. Oh, it smells so nice when you cook this ricotta cheese into the clarified butter, ghee. Now if you think that there is still water that it keeps releasing, normally it doesn't do if it's a fresh one. If you have the fresh ricotta cheese, it shouldn't do that. But for in any case, if it does that, then you can add the instant milk powder to thicken it up fast. And this is very handy. I always keep this in my pantry anytime, because it's basically in India most of the sweets are made from the reduced the milk is boiled, simmered and reduced up to 85%, and then it is made very thick mawa out of that. So that is what normally used in most of the sweets that is made in India. So if you have a time at home and if you would like to make, it's pretty easy. You just have to take the fat milk and then boil, simmer till it gets thick enough, and it's not liquidy and it can hold even the spatula like that. And that's what you want to make. You want to make the consistency like of the mawa. But I normally make from that instant dry non-fat milk powder, and it works best for me. It's less time consuming. Alright, so it looks like that there is no water into our ricotta cheese. You can see that it has thickened up a little bit. I don't see any water in here. So what I'm gonna do is I am gonna put it on the side and then add just a little bit more ghee, a clarified butter, maybe again like 1/4 tablespoon of ghee. And here I'm gonna add this besan, the gram flour, chana no lot, and I'm just gonna roast this besan a little bit. Now if you're making in a big quantity, you might not be able to do this, but since I am using this small amount of everything, I can just manage to do it in the same pan. So I still have the temperature on a medium heat, medium to low, but you can always adjust. You don't want to do this recipe when you are in hurry. Start making this recipe when you think that you have time today and you would like to prepare it with the great patience. That's where you can prepare this recipe. Now if it sticks to the spatula, then you can just take it off, because it's a very small amount. It's hard to roast it that way. All right. It smells so great when you roast even the besan, the gram flour, in clarified butter, ghee. And as I said, be very careful. When you add the ghee, the clarified butter, because we don't want too much of ghee in here. So we're just gonna roast this chana no lot, even the besan, just a little bit. So our besan, the gram flour, is almost about to get it done. And then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna add all other ingredients, and we're gonna let this cool completely. And then add the sugar. So the sugar actually we're gonna add when it's cooled down completely, because if you add into the hot mixture, then it will release the water, which we don't want. All right, so now I'm gonna mix the ricotta cheese and the gram flour that we roasted a little bit. And also I'm gonna add other rest of the things into the ricotta cheese. So the ricotta cheese has thickened up, and the besan, the gram flour, is also roasted a little bit. So I'm gonna add now this the rava that we just roasted a little bit, the semolina or suji. So I'm gonna add that in here, and I'm also going to add this the pistachio powder in here and the powdered almond. So now everything is in here, so I'm gonna give it a stir everything now. So stir everything together, and don't worry if you cannot mix it very well. You can, when it cools down, you can use your hand to mix it very well, but I'm gonna try my best to mix everything. It looks gorgeous. If it sticks to your spatula, then you can take the spoon out and then you can scrub from the spatula. Alright, so this is good. Now I'm gonna take off this mixture into the another plate so that it cools down faster. So we have the mixture ready and I'm going to put it on the side to let it cool down completely. Now I have here this, now we are going to make the layer. Now this is the filling and we're going to prepare now the layer. So I have this 1 cup of all-purpose flour, and to that I'm going to add about 4 tablespoons of ghee. You do need the sufficient amount of ghee to knead this dough, because you want to make the crispy layer of, not the chewy or hard. So I'm taking the about 4 tablespoons of ghee, and I'm going, it is melted. I melted into the microwave, so use the melted ghee to incorporate into the flour very well. So we're going to knead the dough, and I have this cold water to knead the dough. Make sure that you have the cold water, not the hot water, because then it will make the your dough very sticky. So into this all-purpose flour, the ghee, clarified butter. Take all the ghee. Even you can pour, sprinkle some flour, and then take all the ghee from the bowl. All right, mix the ghee very well into the flour, the all-purpose flour, maida. So this is what you need. You should be able to make like a muthiya, that much amount of ghee you need. So if you feel that it is dry, then you might want to add a little bit more ghee. Okay, so this is enough. Look at it, I can make the muthiya easily, the dumplings. And then I have this cold water, and add water slowly, and keep kneading the dough. Do not add all water at the same time, and you want to make the soft dough. It is pretty easy. So almost about to get our dough ready. Just a little bit water, touch. Okay, so this is good consistency. You can see that it's not much hard and not too soft. You should be able to roll easily, because we're gonna roll them like a thin as much as possible. All right, so the dough is ready. Just to look a little bit dry, just a little bit water. I'm gonna, that is it. This should work now. All right, okay, good. So the dough is ready, and to smooth out this dough, I'm gonna use again just a little bit of ghee, a clarified butter, just a little bit. So this helps us to smooth out the dough, and we have a good time rolling it. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna cover this and let it rest for about 10-15 minutes, and it works best when you cover it and let it sit on the counter for about 15-20 minutes. So we have our dough ready, and I'm going to cover it and let it sit onto the counter. Now the mixture that we prepared, it has a cool down a little bit. It's a warm, just a warm. So at this time with my hand, I'm gonna mix it very well. It looks nice green color, and that is what we want. It hasn't cooled down yet, so I'm gonna wait till it gets cooled down completely to add the sugar. I am so curious to give it a taste. I taste my food more than I eat. even without sugar, it's almost there. Now imagine when we're gonna add the sugar, it's gonna taste exactly like the one like sold in India. Anything that is you know, flavored with the pistachio and cardamom powder, I always love it, always. All right, leave it alone. We're gonna let it cool. Now this mixture has cooled down completely, so now it's time to add the sugar sweetness. All right, so I'm using my traditional dabba to take out the sugar from. Now I'm gonna, it's everyone's preference, like whether you want sweet or semi-sweet, or it always depends how sweet you want. So I'm gonna add 1 tablespoon first, or actually 2 tablespoons will be the most that we need first, and I'm gonna mix it very well. So I added 2 tablespoons of sugar and mix it, and if possible use the granulated sugar, and then you can give it a taste. If you need more, you can always add. This is the best part for particularly this sweet, that you can add the sugar last and then you can adjust to your taste. It is mixed very well now, and I'm gonna give it a taste again. I can't explain you how good this tastes once you add the sugar. Oh my god, it is even better than you buy from, you know, the store bought. It is even better than that because it's a fresh. Healthy cooking starts with the home kitchen. That's what I believe. And for me, I think this is gonna be it. 2 tablespoons of sugar, since my kids might eat this as well, so I don't want them to get more excited with this sweet. So I think that will be it for me. But you can always adjust to your taste. It always depends how sweet you want, because there's gonna be layer on top as well, which has no sugar at all. So if you wanna make it more sweet, you are most welcome to do that. Now what I'm going to do is, I'm gonna make the small balls out of it so that it's easy to fill in. So you can choose your own size. I am just gonna make the golf size, or even smaller than golf size ball, because I want a itty bitty tiny gari. But normally in India they're big one, which you cannot even eat that big piece. So I'm just gonna customize it to my need, and I'm gonna make even smaller than golf size. I am finished making my balls even, and remember that we had our dough sitting on the counter for about 10-15 minutes now and ready to roll. So what I'm gonna do is, from the dough even, we're gonna make the small balls. Now this 1 cup, 1 cup of all-purpose flour is more than enough. So, but I had other plan on my mind as well. So normally if you can make even from the 1/2 cup, that will be enough for to, you know, fill these gharis. So 1/2 cup of all-purpose flour is enough, because this make 9 balls. So we only need 9 balls from the all-purpose flour dough as well. So 1/2 cup of flour is. My mother-in-law, she wanted to fill some gugra, the one that I showed earlier. So we prepared just a little bit of than what I needed for this recipe. So I have already made the balls and I'm ready to roll. So the rolling pin, and take the small ball and a couple of times press with your fist, and then make again smooth and press and make the small flat kind of circle, and roll it as much thin as you can, because we got small balls anyway, so the medium size of a puri will be enough. So this size is the perfect size even for this gari to fill in. All right, so I have rolled it and ready to put this. And what I'm gonna do is, I'm gonna make the half moon. I'm gonna cover it just like that with the half moon and seal it very well. Be very careful with the sealing, because you don't want to break them while you're frying them. So very important, if you need to take more dough, take more dough, and you can just cut it off from the side. but be sure you do it properly. So I'm going to take off the excessive part using the knife, and then the excessive dough you can take it off with your knife
and try to make it again the round.
Then seal the edges properly
and then just press firmly.
And what you can
do
is you can keep
very
doing
hard
this
on it. You have to
and
work
keep pressing
with
firmly
your soft hand and then press it like that. Keep doing this
and
keep pressing,
keep sealing the edges at the same time.
The first one is ready. It looks gorgeous, isn't it?
That is it. So the ghari is ready.
Now if you're not frying your ghari right away, then take the cloth and then put it inside and then cover it and get dry and put it on the side and keep making rest of the ghari. You can also put your dough into the container like this so that it doesn't dry out. I have prepared a few ghari here and I have the oil heating here, almost about to get done. Keep the temperature on high in the beginning and then you can bring it down to the medium heat while when you start frying. The oil seems to be ready, but you can give it a try. Take just a small amount of dough, the all-purpose flour dough that we prepared, and if it comes out on the top right away, then the oil is done. The oil is done. It started coming on top. Alright, so the oil is done and we are ready to fry the gharis now.
So carefully we're gonna place our gharis one by one. And before even you put, just try to seal as much as you can again. If you see any crack or if you see the ghee coming out of it, then try to seal again. Alright, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put it on here to be on the safe side. And then put it into the pan. See, this one has again the ghee came out of it, and so you might want to seal that again. And do not try to fry too many at the same time. And then safely turn it over on the other side. We don't want to fry it too much. See, this one has opened up because it wasn't properly sealed maybe. So that's why you need to seal them very good. Alright. You can still use this one, but then I'm going to take it off so that it doesn't get off of the... You can just press it like that and it will seal again a little bit. Just like that. But it's good to take out from the oil if it has, opened up like that. Okay, and I'm gonna put it onto the paper towel. Okay, so the rest of the gharis are good. So I'm gonna take out all of them now because I can see the few brown spots on here. So ready to take out all. And I'm gonna fry rest of my gharis. Alright, so look at that. If you have a few like this, maybe one or two, you can still use it because it will cover up the layer of the sugar and the clarified butter that we're going to do afterwards. So you don't have to worry about it. It will hide everything. Now before you glaze your ghari with the sugar and the ghee, you have to vigorously mix it, and ghee and the clarified ghee and the sugar, you have to vigorously stir and make kind of glaze just like we make for the donut. We're gonna do that later once this ghari has cooled down completely. So it almost takes about 4 hours, at least 4 hours, then you can do the glaze on it. So I'm gonna keep doing rest of my gharis now, and then we will do the the sugar and the ghee, the clarified butter glaze on the ghari. And now it's time to glaze. It has been resting for almost 4 hours now. As I said, you have to let it cool down completely. So it's been now 4 hours. And I'm going to glaze them with the sugar now. Sugar and the ghee, clarified butter. So I have this, I'm going to take the ghee, clarified butter in here.
And to that I have this powdered sugar. You need to have the powdered sugar to do the glaze. So I'm gonna take, I have about 1/2 tablespoon of ghee, and to that I'm going to add about 2 tablespoon of sugar. So that should be enough, but if you need more then you can add more sugar. Mix it very well. Enough now, and work should work for us. So now I'm going to take one gauri at a time, and we're going to dip inside the glaze, and then with your finger or something, if you can find the spatula, just spread it over everywhere, all over, just like that. And I'm gonna finish my rest of the gharis, and then it will be ready to serve in 1/2 hour. Once you glaze it, you can serve in about 1/2 hour. And if you have something like the crack, the one that we had the crack, you can always do this, and then you can hide any crack. You can hide any crack like that. So look at this. I already did 3 of our gharis. Look at them. It looks just like the store bought. And I'm gonna finish my rest of the gharis. And on the top, you can decorate a little bit with the slivered almond, just like that. Press it a little bit, and then pistachio. Okay, so this is it. And look at them, it looks now delicious. Let's cut one of these from the center so you can actually see how it looks inside even. Ooh, look at that. It is yummy. Give it a bite to this wonderful looking gharis. I can't tell you how good it is. The taste is exactly like what you have been eating in India. Proven recipe that I got from my sister, and it does work. So enjoy. Thank you for watching, and see you real soon with the next recipe. I have gone through all the trial and error, so this is it. You don't have to do any more, and you can try this recipe anytime. You can also add a green color to it. My sister makes the green gharis, so she adds a little bit of color to it. But if you would like to keep it just as it is, just I did, it looks gorgeous even without color. So if you would don't like to add the color, any food color to your recipes, then you can skip adding that. But the color looks so nice, beautiful with the green. This way even it works good without color even. So I'm just gonna keep it without color. You can also add a little bit, just a drop of color to this glaze as well. Just a Kelly green works best, the Kelly green color. So you can add even a little bit to this glaze as well, and then to the mixture, and you will get the nice great green color gharis. Look at the gharis. The plate looks so wonderful. I'm really thankful to my sister. She inspired me to make this recipe, and this is very good that you learn for the culture. You know, this is specially made for on the, as I said, the festival Chandi Padwa. And I'm glad that I made it and I can distribute to my relatives here in the neighborhood. So this was it. So far I have been thinking that making gharis is a really hard job, so that's why I didn't even try before. But ever since my sister started telling me that, oh, she makes the you know, gharis, and my brother-in-law, he really loves it, so I'm like, okay, I'm gonna try it then. And all you have to do is just make the filling, make the layer, fry it, and then glaze it. That is all you have to do. So you can never go wrong with this recipe unless you do something different. And I will post all the recipes that you can make even with the mawa, or you already saw that I made with the ricotta cheese today. The ricotta cheese, and the result is great in front of you. So if you would like to use even ricotta cheese, that's great too. And the fresh mawa works also great.